Sisters Lucy and Kate Backhouse come from a long line of woodchoppers. Excited to be competing at Sydney's Royal Easter Show, dubbed the Wimbledon of woodchopping, they've just been fined and banned. The reason? Taking too long to chop. So here are the girls swinging away a few days ago. The buzzer rings telling them to stop, but they keep chopping. The crowd loving it. And Lucy and Kate join me. They've got an axe to grind. Girls, you're giving the crowd what they wanted. Why is the wood chopping committee so unhappy with you?
We have no idea. We are there to entertain the crowds. We are paid for the block. We like to chop it in half. There's nothing more that we hate than leaving it in one piece. So the crowd love to get behind us and they like to see us beat it. So we have no idea what the deal is.
Okay, so Lucy, just take me through it. What happened exactly?
So Kate competed in a women's underhand handicap event on this past Sunday, and there is a time limit that they impose now. So if you are not finished within 2 minutes from the back marker, there is a buzzer that goes off around the arena and you're told to stop, and an official will tell you to stop. Kate was almost finished. She only had to drive a couple more hits. She finished the log, the crowd went crazy. I was videoing Kate in the crowd and I had women next to me that were crying because they were so happy that she finished. Our dad gave her a hug and yeah, we were very proud of her.
So Kate, your crime here was that you dared to finish.
Yeah, I just guessing they didn't like it, obviously. Who knows with them? Mm-hmm.
Then Lucy, someone also had a word with you.
That's right. I had a couple of open events, so that means events with the men. And I competed in a standing block event, so that's the vertical block that you might see at the show. And I'm only one of two women that compete in that event. So I competed and when I was almost finished, my time was up apparently, and I had an official tell me to stop. I had the crowd behind me though telling me to keep going. They were there to support me and so I kept going. I don't like leaving them in one piece, so I finished and I was proud of myself for doing that.
Well, you had a job to do, right? And you made sure you did it. You know what? I love watching you guys do your thing, taking on the blokes, because when we went to like wood chopping at the show as a kid, it was only men. But you've had to fight pretty hard, right, to even be out there competing.
It's been a constant fight. That's what it feels like anyway. I've been chopping since I was 11 years old. I first competed at the Easter show when I was 12. Kate first competed at the Easter show when she was 12. It was hard. It was a fight just to be able to compete in the junior development program. That was the first fight. And then we had to fight to be able to chop with Dad in a what was called the father and son event and is now called the parent and child event. And now this as well. So it feels like a constant battle just to be able to compete in the sport that we love. And not only that, we pay a lot of money to go to the show and to pay for these blocks. Just for me alone, it cost almost $900 just for the logs. And now I won't be able to chop them anyway.
So how did you find out that you'd been banned until the end of the show and fined $100?
So I received a message yesterday. It was a letter for Kate and I saying that we had been summoned to an RAS boardroom and we were going to be escorted in and we had to explain ourselves and our conduct. And I almost couldn't believe what I was reading. And when I had been then called by the committee, I explained what my thinking was and why we did what we did. And I also pointed out a few inconsistencies with their rules as well and what they abide by and don't abide by. And I don't think they were too happy with that.
You know what I love about you, Lucy? You didn't sit back and cop it, did you? You took the fight to them. But, I mean, it's not like you swore at them at all. You went past a time buzzer. Do you think it's pretty unfair to then ban you from the rest of the show? Because, Lucy, I know that you and your dad were meant to be competing together on Saturday.
Yes, Dad and I were supposed to chop together on Saturday in the parent and child event. So that's a team event where one of us will cut the underhand and the other will cut the standing block. So usually I cut the standing block just because there aren't many women who can do it. So that's why I was going to do that, but seems like that's not going to happen.
You know, I'm just looking at that big pile of wood behind you. Have you taken your anger out on it?
not yet. We only found out yesterday, so got plenty of time to do that, I think.
Look, I mean, you come from a long line of wood choppers. What would Granddad say about this?
Yeah, Charlie, I don't think he'd be too happy about it. We've had a long history with the sport. Our older brothers, our younger brother, our dad, our uncles, and our grandfather Charlie. So it's definitely a family sport. We love the sport, and none of us are happy at the moment, but...
Okay, well, I think we make the plea tonight to the Woodchopping and Sawing Committee that they overturn this ban. Lucy, I think we'd all love to see you out there with your dad on Saturday competing. And can I also just say, I reckon the committee's braver than me because I wouldn't mess with a girl who can swing an axe.
That's what we're thinking too.
All right, well, keep up the good fight, legends. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks. See ya.
Aren't they fabulous?